champion, Eric Bristow. His opponent from England, Keith Geller. Best of five sets, three legs to a set, six darts practice, please.
Keith Geller, well, it's good to see the Geller fella back on a main stage in a big television final. Of course, a replay of that World Championship when he conquered Eric Bristow here. Bristow, who has only just dropped one set throughout the whole of this 1984 World Masters. Geller recently engaged his fiancée Kim Ovens, is just in a table near the stage. Says she's brought him luck. Well, he's in a big final again. Bristow, who establishes such an important psychological hold over most opponents. Well, it doesn't work with Geller. Geller certainly isn't frightened of Eric Bristow, and we have a marvellous final in prospect.
Please. First set, first leg. And it's Keith to throw first. Game on.
Geller has won the toss. That may well turn out to be important in the final analysis. The rainbow suite settles down, packed to the rafters. Heaving, you might say.
95.
And this is the 11th staging of the Win Now World Masters. The final, Eric Bristow bidding for his fifth hand.
100.
Straight into the tongue routine. Bristow here has virtually taken apart the Irish team on his own. He's beaten three Irishmen: Gordon Bond, Steve Brennan, and Freddie McMullen.
140.
Geller has beaten, of course, John Lowe, which was a sweet moment for him after that defeat in the World Match Play against the nine dart finish.
95.
And a reminder that there is a carrot, a golden carrot indeed, for a nine dart checkout here in this final. £12,000 a bonus.
60.
Bristow is what, 10 ahead in this first leg of the first set.
60.
Needs to come out now, come down for 57. Absolutely measured dart play. Leads him 212. Geller wants 151. Full order. Still on though, come down for 317s. He's missed the treble.
97 score. The goal requires 24.
Could be a 13 dart checkout for Bristow in this first leg. Now two sixes.
Yes, first leg,
Eric Bristow. Yes, 15 darts only, and Bristow clearly means business.
Second leg, Eric Knight first. England, please.
Crafty Cockney has been stung by the rumours around the world of darts of his former slipping.
60.
I see he points out he hasn't lost a title yet, and he is determined to hang on to this one. £7,500 to him. A whole lot of prestige though.
41.
As it's true to character, Bristow will punish that scoring lapse by Keith Geller. Yes, he's hit the treble and there's a lot of it still showing. Tremendous. Bristow is going for Geller's jugular vein.
60.
They've had their odd moments of intimidation and anguish, these two. In fact, just before the last World Pro, Eric confidently wrote off Geller as a dead loss.
140.
Danner has described by beating the crafty Cockney in several big money matches, including one in the Emirates, so he certainly isn't overawed by him.
59, and it requires 121.
121 for this first set. 17A going. So single 18 came across for the treble. Still time to play with for Eric Bristow, with Keith Denner back on 341.
100! And Eric requires 32.
It's a rare occasion when Bristow misses these.
Yes! First set, Eric Bristow!
Well, that's a checkout in 13 darts, so what, that set took him 28 arrows.
First leg, second set, Eric to throw first.
Bristow did take that first set against the strike. He's going with the strike here, and look at this start.
140!
Irrepressible. Denner really has to find his peak. And Michael Myron, he is responding magnificently to the task, not letting Bristow establish too much daylight.
100.
Neither of them have missed a score of 100 or more in this leg. First of the second set.
85. Eric requires 121.
Eric wanted this one in his last leg. He came down for 317s then. 79 going. Now 16, two eights.
Yes!
Oh, what a finish.
You
simply cannot play against that. 121 he wanted, 317s, 318s, two eights. Irresistible.
Second leg, it's Keith Rodenfors.
Game on, please. Danner has somehow got to find the character and the scoring and the finishing to compete with Bristow at his very best.
137!
It's one of the most difficult assignments in the whole wide world of sport.
60!
Denner here has edged in front already at the top of this second leg, and that's another tremendous maximum 180. And Bristow is replying. Unbelievable. Audience here at the Rainbow Suite, a lot of players from emerging nations like Uganda, and they really just cannot believe what they're seeing. Maybe one or two of us more experienced darts campaigners can't either.
100. He requires 124.
124 for Della to level up the second set. Got to come for 318s. Should have done. Bristow has got a three dart finish.
60.
Would have left in the ball.
161.
It would be just like to. Bristow's character to step in here on 161. Not now though. First start in single 20. Gotta come out.
137! Keith requires 64.
Denner on 64. Now 18 left, two eights. Oh, yes! Again, he can match the finishing power.
Keith Denner!
14 darts. The crowd here are aware they are. In the presence of a real special event. Good spirit here. And Bristow first leg he's lost in the final. He usually responds.
140!
That has allowed Bristow to gain an awful lot of ground at the top of this deciding leg of the second set.
140!
Second successive 10-40 takes him down to 221. He's now had six darts.
60!
His luck downstairs. Unquestionably, Bristow has applied an awful lot of early pressure on Denny. Hopes to break his spirit. Like he has.
135!
Now then, just two darts away from the second set. Needs 96 next time.
60. Oak requires 96.
Now two 18s.
Yeah!
The finishing really is devastating.
Harry Bristow.
Keith Deller, who, it has to be said, has not played at all badly. In fact, he's played very well.
100.
Very well is not sufficient when Eric Bristow is at his brilliant best. Then he really is peerless. Can he maintain that pace, that pressure?
25. Okay.
May come down for 319, yes, and does so successfully. More handily placed in this leg than he's been throughout the match, Master Dunner.
60!
Using the first two darts as a deflection for the third into the treble there.
140.
Bristow filling it up.
140! He requires 104.
Should come over for 18s here. Doesn't. 84 now going. 60 would leave him his favourite two 12s. I think that was probably his aim there.
88 score!
Takes him down to what, 16-8 next time, and he will have a shot at it as Eric Bristow here on 176.
140!
Keeping all the pressure on Deller, Bristow's on a double, and Deller wants 2-8s, and that one must block his view of certainly part of the double.
Yes!
But not enough. Brilliant piece of realignment from Deller. 17 dart kill. Takes the first leg of the third set. Got to win this set, of course.
Second leg, Eric Rainfires. Game on, please. 100.
Well, can Denner summon the sinew? and take the leg against the darts here against Bristow.
100.
It's in the treble. And the second dart isn't.
140.
Bristow certainly kicking on here, 100, 140, 100, down at a three dart finish on 161 next throw.
140! It requires 161.
Coming down for 319.
Score.
Gets the single. Really tall ton from Denner could change the face of this second leg of the set. Luck running low there off the wire on the treble 20, quite clearly.
18 on the
recovering lucky. Well, he needs the sign of a class player there.
102.
He should come for the ball now. It leaves him 2-16s. He loves to go that way. Bristow, we know, uses the ball as part of his combination finishing. We saw a classic example of it there. And now he's just one leg away from his fifth World Masters title. Well, Keith Denner really having terrible luck with that first start. He's got to win this leg.
18.
Bristow, one senses moving in, sensing the kill. Denner can only just keep banging the tons, hitting the scores. He's got to keep ahead here. And not much of that trouble to aim at. And again, he's lost a dart. He really cannot afford to lose, what, 20% of your scoring power on the first two throws of a leg you've got to win against the crafty Cockney. Bristow has not really stepped in, still the scores are level, so Denner has retained the advantage of the throw.
60.
The tension, we have to say, is touchable. Deflection for Bristow there into the one. This is far healthier for Deller. Maximum might just be the critical point of this third set. And Bristow, of course, is replying in kind. Incredible. Denner wants 141, they're still far from finished. And 121.
60. Eric requires 160.
For the match, Eric Bristow would love to do a finish with the flowers. These two trebles. Not all night.
100. Eric requires 8.
Could be his last dart if he misses. 81 he wants. Now 66, he'll come for 16. 18 left, 2 9s, and his calculator was working. Went for 16 to leave the ball, I believe. We've got the treble left, 2 9s, quickly readjusted. The match is still on and still buzzing.
First leg, fourth set with Eric going first. Game on, please.
Bristow then, first with the darts in this, the fourth set, and starting in his usual tremendous gap.
penalty.
Whatever the outcome of this final, it has to be said that Keith Deller is well and truly back in the big time. He really showed all his character there. Produced the finish just when it was required. It really was a thinking player's finish. Crafty company Eric Bristow. Now just 100 on. Deller has swung. It's a single 19.
58.
You don't often see players trying their hand quite so early on 19s. Well, 166, of course, one of the bunker numbers. No three-dart finish on this, but Eric will wish to leave himself usefully placed on his next visit to the board.
82.
Getting that switch to the lower trebles most effective.
60. Eric requires 84.
Well, 84 his target. Now, which way will Bristow go? What's 64? He's got to come over for 16s now. 16 left, two eights.
68 scoring. Keith requires 143.
Well, 143 is attainable. Needs 61st start and has not found it.
41. Eric requires 16.
A brave man to bet against Bristow in this league now.
Yes! First leg, Eric Bristow.
Deller just has
second leg, key to go first.
Odd lapse there, and again, he's losing darts early in the leg and recovering well.
80, unlucky.
Deller needs to take this leg, otherwise his chance in the 1984 Masters is gone.
140!
It's a punishing opening from Eric Bristow.
140!
Unable to fault Deller's grit and determination. He's hung on to this whirlwind called Eric Bristow like a mongrel, snapping at his heels.
100!
Close call again. Deller has got to win this leg to stay in the Masters title chase.
60. Eric requires 161.
Again, he'd love to retain his title with a flourish. 161 now. 317s will leave the ball. Yes, the ball. Is this going to be the golden moment? Sections away.
36 score. Unlucky.
And now Deller has got to produce the party piece on 136, and he isn't going to.
60, and Eric requires 25.
Eric Bristow wants 25, 9, 2 eights. There's the 9, he's got 2 darts, or 2 eights.
9 scores,
and that's really must be regarded as a historical moment. Deller with a rare chance, 76. And he's got 2 darts at 2 eights. And he's missed as well. that surely will be his chance.
16.
Bristow. 2-4s now. Yeah! He is the champion. He has retained his title. Who can question that this man is off form? We have seen another masterly performance by Eric Bristow, the world master, and he truly is back, the master.
Champion, and it's presentation time. Could I please ask for Winifred Gix? Please, Winifred. And Harry Gix Jr., Managing Director of the Winmore Dartboard Company, the Dealio Bells. I'm sure we've got a check for the champion for £7,500. But certainly, what a worthy champion, because when you consider this is his fifth World Masters title, the 1984 champion, Eric Bristow. Stage, please, David, I'll hand over to you. One or two words from the champion.
Thank you very much, Tony. Eric, well, once again, our congratulations. We're getting to make a habit of this. I know you've been a little bit stung because various people have said that you've been slightly off form in major competitions. Today, surely, that was a complete answer.
Yeah, I thought I played well all the way through. You know, you've only seen the last three or four games on TV, but I'd like to thank all the players that have played against me, especially Freddie McMullen. He played brilliant in that semi-final. Young man from Ireland, a lot of pressure on him, done well. I'm chuffed, I won it five times, and all the lads at the club have been well chuffed.
How many more times can you go on winning? Five times the master, Eric. I mean, how much longer can you go on dominating this championship in this way?
I just keep going, Dave, you know what I mean? I can say 10 years, 15 years, or whatever, I don't know. I enjoy participating, I enjoy winning. Winning's a bonus, but it's nice when you've got 27 countries here involved in the game of darts that started off in England or Great Britain. I've got this lot. And it's great. You know, you look around this hall and it's people from all over the world, and that's how far this game of darts has gone.
Well, number one, you've proved it quite conclusively today. From all of us on ITV World of Sport, many congratulations. Well done.
I think Vera will be happy. All right, Vera.